Merry Christmas, friends. Grace to you and peace. My name is Jonathan Hauze. I'm the new pastor here at Norwich Congregational Church, and it is my honor to welcome you to our Christmas Eve worship service. We pray that tonight finds you healthy and well, and that this service will be a time of blessing for you as we rejoice together in the gift of Christ's birth. While we had hoped to gather in person this year with the sanctuary filled to overflowing, tonight we take heart in the promise that there is no barrier or distance that can keep Christ from coming to us, whether we are gathered or scattered. The promise that our lives are most truly shaped and our future most truly determined, not by the fact that we live in a world with COVID, but by the proclamation that we live in a world with Christ. Tonight, we will journey in heart and mind to Bethlehem, where a child has been born for us, a child whose birth will be a great joy for all people. We will hear the song of angels and hasten with the shepherds to see this thing that has taken place. We will walk with the Magi as they follow a star. And with them, we will meet our morning star, whose dawning is the redemption of the world. At the lowly stable, we will encounter a holy mystery, the Word made flesh, the glory of God making a home among us, the inaccessible light of heaven come to us to dwell within our own being, to make all things new. As the scripture says, and the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. So come, friends, and hear again the good news of God's steadfast love for the world. Come, let us adore him. Christ the Lord.
Thank you.
We gather, O God, to remember the ancient promise that your light has shined on people who dwelled in darkness, that your love has come to those who have borne tremendous griefs and waited in long weariness for the morning to come. We come to you, God, to remember, to rejoice, to remind ourselves and each other, to recall our own vision and sense of purpose in the light of your promise and your steadfast love. God, grant that we may be transformed, that our hearts may be enlarged, that our spirits may be refreshed in our journey, following the star to the stable in Bethlehem. In Christ we pray. Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here ends the reading.
Joyful. from the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Sure, he must have been surprised at where this road had taken him. Cause never in a million lives would he have dreamed of Bethlehem. And standing at the manger, he saw with his own eyes the message from the angel come to pass. And Joseph said, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here? Inside this stable built with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say. This is such a strange way to save the world.
Think of how it could have been if Jesus had come as he deserved. There would have been no Bethlehem, no lowly shepherds at his birth. But Joseph knew the reason love had to reach so far, and as he held the Savior in his arms, he must have thought, "Why me? I'm just a simple man of trade. Why him with all the rulers in the world? Why here? Inside this stable filled with hay, why her? She's just an ordinary girl. Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say. This is such a strange way to save the world. Oh,
Now I'm not one to second guess what angels have to say. But this is such a strange way to save the world. This is such a strange way. Such a strange way. A strange way to save the world.
Reading from the second chapter of the Gospel of Luke. In those days a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Second chapter of the Gospel of Luke. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace, goodwill among people."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
Gospel of Matthew. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who's been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for it so has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Gospel of Matthew, Jesus teaches us that where our treasure is, there our hearts will be also. Christmas is a time to unify our lives, to unify our desires, to reconnect our prayers and our cares with the treasures that we have received, so that our whole lives may be turned to the love of God and neighbor. Tonight, we invite you to be our partner in ministry by supporting our local mission fund that enables us to serve our neighbors in need. 100% of your Christmas Eve gifts will go to support this fund, and we are deeply grateful for every gift, no matter how small, that helps us to shine the Christ light in our community. Thank you. Will you pray with me? Holy One, bless the gifts that we bring to the manger with humble hearts, that they may help to build the peaceable kingdom, the realm of love that has come near to us this night. Bless our whole lives that we may come to see every encounter with one another as an opportunity to adore the Christ child with humility, gentleness, and generosity. And grant that by your grace, the work that we do together in your church and in the community may help to bring glad tidings to our neighbors near and far. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
The story of Christmas teaches us to look for God's coming, not among the great and powerful, but among the humble and lowly, the ones for whom the world has no room.
When Christ is born, the dark places of this world begin to shine from within with the light of eternal love.
Light of Christ, the hope of the world, come and worship the newborn King, whose love now dawns over all the creation, bringing peace and healing, comfort and joy.
In one of his books of meditations, the pastor and mystic Howard Thurman wrote these lines about the candles of Christmas. He wrote, "I will light candles this Christmas, candles of joy despite all sadness, candles of hope where despair keeps watch, candles of courage for fears ever present, candles of peace for tempest-tossed days, candles of graces to ease heavy burdens, candles of love to inspire all my living, candles that will burn all the year long." Now, wherever you are, I invite you to light a candle. And to pause in silence for just a moment to cherish the Christ light that is given to you this night. To set your will and your heart on the intention to keep this light burning in your heart all the year long.
Oh,
extinguish this candle. But this light, the Christ light, continues to shine. Let it shine. Let us pray now for the needs of the world, that what is broken may be made whole, that those who weep may rejoice, that the songs of angels may be heard on every hillside and in every heart. Will you pray with me? We pray, Blessed One, for peace and goodwill among people, for health and healing, for the weak and weary to be raised up with new strength and with enduring hope, remembering that Christ came to us in poverty and that there was no room for him in this world, that his birth was a precarious thing. We remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold and the hungry, the abused, exploited, and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and those who mourn, the isolated and the lonely, the elderly and the little children, the prisoner and the stranger. We remember all who are lost or afraid or who are far from home. In your mercy, be close to all and bless them with your peace. Lastly, O God, we remember before you all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we are one forevermore. Loving One, receive our prayers and grant that our whole lives may become a prayer of peace and praise. Grant that the love and light of Christ may shine in us for the blessing of all. For we ask this in his name, as he taught us to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Merry Christmas, everybody, and hopefully we will all be COVID-free. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone. We wish you a joyous and happy new year.
Chipper
and Terry.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas from Jenny and Smith.
Wishing all of you a happy and safe 2022 and looking forward to being together at Christmas next year.
Merry Christmas,
everyone. It's so wonderful to be back with our community at Norwich Church. We're excited for this holiday season and sorry we aren't gathering in person, but we hope to see you in church after Christmas. Merry, merry. Have a wonderful one.
Best wishes.
We just want to wish everyone a very happy Christmas Eve and a very Merry Christmas.
Wishing you a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas from Annie, Julia, Cedar, and Skye.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
See you soon.
There is no doubt in our minds that we are blessed.
We are so grateful for all of you,
and we wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
This is Rita and John Sevenhouse, and we are wishing you a blessed Christmas and a healthy and simple New Year.
Merry Christmas.
Hi, this is Sally.
And Mark.
We are the Alloways, and we'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a happy and healthy New Year.
Happy holidays!
We love the Norwich Congregational Church.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
This is Doug and Ellen.
Wishing you a very Merry Christmas.
And a happy and blessed New Year.
Merry Christmas from Gary and Barbara.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Peace and joy be with you all.
Merry Christmas from the Greens in Hanover, New Hampshire.
Wishing you a joyful Merry Christmas, Zara Reeves.
Hi, it's Ryan Adams here wishing everyone a really Merry Christmas. And may 2022 be a year of good health and no more COVID. Auf Wiedersehen.
Merry Christmas!
From the Hauze family.
Peace on earth.
Goodwill to all.
And a happy new year!
As the shepherds left the stable, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard, go now in joy. To be a witness to the glad tidings of peace on earth, goodwill among all people. Go in peace and let Christ be born in you, that his light may be yours and yours his forevermore. Amen.